Hi, in this new tutorial we will see how we can use the animate option in the edit poly modifier so that if we are at any sub object level and we use one of these options here, we can later on, if we add another modifier on top of it, we can go back and modify the settings that we did here, and this will make things more flexible for us. So let's try now. I'm in the polygon sub-object level. I will click animate. I will select this polygon here. I will use the bevel. I will choose the height and the outline. Now I will add another edit poly on top of it. I don't have to choose the animate. I will keep it model for modeling, and I will go to polygon again, and I will choose this polygon here. I will do some inset first, and then I will extrude. Now let's say that the bevel that I did here in this edit poly, I don't like the values that I've chosen. I can go back here, and because I choose the animate, I can click on this button here, setting, and the bevel dialog will open up, and I can see the values that I used here. I can modify them. And what I did in this last edit poly will adapt to it, of course. It's a good feature, and which is something nice to have. For example, here I can click the animate, and I can go to vertex sub object level. I will choose this vertex and this vertex, and I will choose chamfer, and I will chamfer these vertices. Now I will add another edit poly. I will choose these two polygons here. I can choose whatever I want, but I will choose these two here, and I will click extrude. Now if I don't like the value I choose for the chamfer here, I can go back to this one, to this edit poly here. I will click settings, and you can see the chamfer vertex is shows up with the value I've chosen. I can change that. Remember that you can use this animate only with one parameter. For what I mean by that, for example, here I can choose this animate for one of these settings. That means I cannot force Max to remember, for example, two values I've chosen, for example, one for bevel and one for outline. No, Max will remember only the last one I've chosen. So so it's one parameter per modifier. And basically that's it. You can go and experiment with this. It's a nice feature. Actually, this feature here, this option here, was created to be able to animate these parameters here. But we can use it for to do what we've just done here, which is nice. So that's it for this tutorial. And if you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time. Thank you.